Children, let's start the story, A House is Not a Home, where we left in the previous video 4. The next day, that week, the rubble that used to be our house, was being cleared off the lot. Even though we had rented an apartment nearby, I would go over to watch them clear away debris, hoping that my cat was somewhere to be found. Now, the people, those who were clearing the garbage, which earlier used to be his house, and they had rented an apartment nearby that house only. So even though he used to go to that place, which once used to be his house, he was going there in search of his little cat. Even though somewhere he had the hope that he would get him, she was gone. I kept thinking about her as that vulnerable little kitten. He was continuously thinking about his cat and hoping that he should get it, because that was very vulnerable, meaning easily going to be affected by the ill fate. In the early morning, when I would disturb her and get out of bed, she would tag along after me, climb up my robe and crawl into my pocket to fall asleep. I was missing her terribly. He was remembering the happy days spent with his little kitten, and he was thinking, missing her very badly. It always seems that bad news spreads quickly, and in my case, it was no different. See, as it is the universal fact that people take time to get the good news, but bad news, it is the habit of bad news, it spreads very early. So the same thing had happened with his case as well. Everyone in high school, including the teachers, was aware of my plight. I was embarrassed, as if somehow I were responsible. What a way to start off at a new school. This was not the kind of attention I was looking for. See, in his new school, everybody, his teachers, his friend, actually no friends, but other students, they all were aware about his plight, his misfortune. And he was feeling embarrassed, as if he was also responsible somewhere about whatever was happened with his house. He wanted their attention, but of course not this way. The next day at school, people were acting even more strange than usual. I was getting ready for gym class at my locker. People were milling around me, asking me to hurry up. Next day, in school, generally he was not at all comfortable in his school. But that day, everybody was behaving in very strange way. When he was going for his gym class, everybody was just nearby him and they were asking him to hurry up. I thought it strange, but in the light of the past few weeks, nothing would surprise me. It almost seemed that they were trying to shove me into the gym. Then I saw why. There was a big table set up with all kinds of stuff on it just for me. It seems to me that as if everybody was willing to send me to gym very fast. And he was unable to understand, and even his state of mind was as if nothing was going to surprise him. Already lots of shock he got in his life. But the moment he went inside the gym, the thing was absolutely clear. There was a big table, and on that big table, so many things were kept and only for me. They had taken up a collection and bought me school supplies, notebooks, all kinds of different clothes, jeans, tops, sweatsuits. On that table, they had collected some amount, and they have kept everything related to school, notebooks, bags, school related things, clothes, jeans, tops, suitcase, and sweatsuits, everything, whatever he was needing in school. It was like Christmas, because in Christians are exchanging gifts in Christmas, so it seems as if it was his Christmas gift. I was overcome by emotion. People who had never spoke to me before were coming up to me to introduce themselves. I got all kinds of invitations to their houses. Their genuine outpouring of concern really touched me. That was an emotional day for him because everybody was coming. They introduced themselves to him. They invited him to his home and their genuine concern touched him. In that instant, I finally breathed a sigh of relief and thought for the first time that things were going to be okay. I made friends that way. So at least there was a relief sign that things were going to be okay. At least he got his new friends. A month later, I was at my house watching them rebuild it. But this time it was different. I was not alone. I was with two of my new friends from school. So after a month, when I was watching, my house was under construction, and I was observing it. But this time he was not all alone to observe the building of his house. But his two friends were also there. He got friends also, school friends. It took a fire for me to stop focusing on my feeling of insecurity and open up to all the wonderful people around me. Now I was sitting there watching my house being rebuilt when I realized my life was doing the same thing. So now he realized that his house was rebuilding and he realized the same thing was happening in him inside as well. Meaning he was also rebuilding himself. He got his friend, he was constructing himself once again. While we sat there on the crib planning my new bedroom, I heard someone walk up to me from behind and say, "Does this belong to you?" When I turned around to see who it was, I couldn't believe my eyes. A woman was standing there holding my cat. I leapt at and grabbed her out of the woman's arm. I held her close and cried with a beautiful orange fur. She puffed happily. My friend was hugging me, hugging the cat and jumping around. And he noticed once that he sat down there and one lady came and she said, "Is it yours?" A woman was standing near me and she was saying, "Is it yours?" My cat was in her arms and he was happy like anything to get back his cat once again. Thank you, dear children.